Fine. Okay. So we now come to finding the angle between two given lines. Okay. So angle between two lines. Till now, we have found out that the equation of the line can be written as the equation of the line can be given in two ways, right? The first way was R minus A equal to lambda B, okay? And another was R minus A was equal to lambda B1 minus B2, no. So R minus A was lambda B minus A, right? Because in that case our vector was A and B. This was that? Okay. Now you see, so in this case, this is the vector to which the line is parallel, that is vector B. And in the other case, A and B were the direction, they were the position vectors. No, you people have forgotten that. No. See, in the first case, B was a vector to which the line was parallel, correct? And A was something like this. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
And we had said that our general point R is kind of this. So that's why R minus A was lambda B. In the other case, it was slightly different. It was that there were two points which were given. So these are those two points, A and B. A and B. So they are not vectors, right? It is B minus A to which the whole line is parallel. Okay. That means whatever is the vector before which you have got this lambda, that is the unknown arbitrary constant, that is the vector to which it is parallel. Okay. Fine. Now, so I know the vectors to which the lines are parallel. I know the vectors to which the lines are parallel, and I know that whatever is the angle between the vectors will be the angle between the lines. Correct? If you have say this line L and M, and you want to find the angle between them, okay, then what happens if I have a line parallel to L and another line parallel to M? Then the angle between these parallels, the dotteds, they will be the same as the angle between the lines, isn't it? They will be the same as the angle between the lines. So in this case, I am trying to find out the angle between the vectors. Okay? And whenever we have the vectors, they have their direction ratios A1, B1, C1. Right? Whenever I have a line, they have I, j, k components, and those I, j, k components, the coefficients of I, j, k are nothing but the direction ratios which we had decided we will call A1, B1, C1 or ABC. Okay. So in the conclusion, what happens? So we have two vectors. Okay. With their direction ratios dr as a1 b1 c1 and a2 b2 c2 excuse me, I decide to call these vectors b1 and b2 vector. So my b1 vector, to which the line 1 is parallel, is given by a1 I cap plus b1 j cap plus c1 k cap, and the other vector b2, which is given by a2 I cap plus b2 j cap plus c2 k cap. We get that point. Okay. So the whole thing boils down to finding out the angle between these two vectors. Correct. And when we studied the dot product, we had said that dot product helps us in finding out the angle between the vectors. How come? See, what is, I'll do it here. What is B1 dot B2? B1 dot B2 is mod B1 mod B2 into cos theta. Okay, it's mod B1 mod B2 cos theta. Correct. Now that gives me cos theta as equal to B1 dot B2 upon mod B1 mod B2. Correct. Simple. Now, what is b1 dot b2? We have seen, if you have to dot two vectors, what do you do? What do we do? We multiply their corresponding I components, j component, I coefficient, j coefficient and k coefficient, and sum it up. That means it will be a1 into a2, a1 into a2, a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2. And what is the magnitude of the vectors? What is the magnitude of the vectors? Any idea? What is the magnitude of B1? It is? Yes, root over A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square multiplied by A2 square, B2 square, C2 square. Take cos inverse of that, you will get the angle. We get the point. Do we understand? So what happens? My cos theta is given like that. Okay. Now, what happens if instead of the direction ratios you were given the direction cosines. You understand? I was not given the vectors in terms of the direction ratios, rather they were given in terms of direction cosines. Suppose, okay, though it is very rare, but still, so I name it the same vector maybe, it will be defined as L1 I cap, M1 J cap, N1 K cap, B2, L2 I cap, M2 J cap, N2 K cap, isn't it? And what happens is this, I do the same thing, correct? The only thing that you will find here is that, what is mod B1? Can you tell me what is mod B1? Mod B1 is L1 square plus M1 square plus N1 square root over. What is L1 square plus? Correct. So it is root over 1, which is 1. And similarly, mod B2 will be 1. Okay. So there will be just a simple difference in whatever you have got. You will do everything the same. So I will be doing cos theta is equal to B1, B2 upon mod B1, mod B2. This is all 1. So it is just B1 dot B2, and which is L1, L2 plus M1, M2 plus N1, N2. That's all. This is the angle. So we get cos theta is equal to L1, L2 plus M1, M2 plus N1, N2. We understand? Simple? Now, it may so happen that I am interested in finding out sine theta. Okay. Now you will say, if I know cos theta, what's the headache? Why don't you find out the angle from there only? And you will be correct. Yes, I can. But I am doing it for some other purpose. Though it is far more cumbersome, still I am doing it for some other purpose that you will come to understand. Okay. So what happens? Do I erase this? No. Either one.